One of the things that Park City has always been concerned with, as well as the county, is the watershed and the drainage along Silver Creek. The main focus of the EPA coming back to town was to look at that watershed and focus on a cleanup that would effectively address the source areas that are high up on the mountain that were continuing to put contamination in the watershed and having it flow downstream. We're really pleased that the working relationship with the EPA has been such that the source areas are being addressed first and foremost, and then we move on to other areas that need more attention, like the school district properties.
My name is Martin McComb. I'm an on-scene coordinator with EPA's Emergency Response and Removal Program. We basically deal with those type of projects that should happen in the short term, what we call time-critical removals or emergency response actions. So we came to town, started partnering immediately with the Utah Department of Environmental Quality and Park City Municipal to identify those areas a little bit further. That is, we tried to look at the entire watershed and see what areas of priority were, and then we went out and collected some additional sampling and additional information from those source areas. We're partnering with United Park City Mines, who's performing the work. The goal is to put in different features that will stop those sediments from flowing downstream. We'll be putting in things like water bars, culverts, moving the streams away from some of these waste rock piles, and a lot of it will be doing with revegetation, so trying to get some vegetation to grow on top of some of these areas to really hold that soil in place. Park City Municipal brought to our attention a specific area, that is the Treasure Mountain Junior High, that they suggested we should really go in and take a look at. The school was developed in an area that had been impacted by mine tailings before. It's a well-known tailings deposit in Prospector Square. We took some very extensive samples, and we are showing that the soils at the school are impacted, especially the closer you get to Kearns, the closer you get to some of this historic tailings. The elevations of lead in the soil are fairly high. Because there are kids involved, and because the contaminants of concern really do impact kids the most, that we want to take the most conservative approach moving forward. Now that school's out, partnering with the school district is go in and remove the most contaminated soil there. We're really going to be targeting those areas along Kearns Boulevard where those historic tailings were located. Go in and go ahead and remove those soils and make sure that we have a protective cap on them. Biggest impact people can expect is along Kearns Boulevard. We'll have large trucks getting on and off of the road. And we are taking that material just a short distance down to Richardson Flat, about a mile away. So our haul route is going to be short and won't be going through town, but people can expect some delays as we have flaggers out there trying to get our trucks safely on and off of that fairly major road in town.
We have matured into a community that cares deeply about the environment, cares deeply about our open space, and cares deeply about living lightly on the planet and being as healthy a community as we can be. We are no longer a mining community. We're a recreation community, and we all love living here. And because of that, the City Council's vision in the time that I was on City Council, and I think it continues to this day, was that we're a mature enough community to accept the fact that we have areas that are contaminated and need to be cleaned up. And there's no fear in that position. There's just a recognition that there are some less than pleasant legacies from our mining history that we need to address. And I believe the community is fully behind the City Council and the EPA moving forward in a conservative and cautious approach and cleaning up as much as we possibly can.